You're watching the news on Mirror Now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Let's take a look at the top headlines. From Rewari to Kadarpur to Palwal, school girls across Haryana step out in protest, demand protection from sexual harassment. In the meantime, Haryana Chief Minister has all the time to visit a bird sanctuary, but no time to set his state in order. No word yet from the CM on the lawlessness in the state.
They are waiting for another incident to happen, and we are not ready to face another incident of child molestation.
Protesters manhandled outside Queen Mary School in Delhi. Angry parents were protesting against the school after a minor was allegedly abused by the school cab driver. And superstar Rajnikanth keeps his date with fans but keeps the nation guessing on his political plunge. Straight up to our top story, a massive fire broke out at a furniture shop near Gurugram's Patodi Chowk. 8 fire tenders were rushed to the spot to contain the blaze. Now, the fire broke out on the first floor of Kumar Furniture. No casualties have been reported, but property worth lakhs have been destroyed. The fire has been brought under control. We understand Apurva joins us with more details on the phone line. Apurva, tell us what caused the fire.
Well, Amita, a massive fire broke out at the Gurgaon Patodi Chowk, and we understand that the fire broke out at a furniture shop that was owned by a man, certain man named Kumar Beg. And the reason for the fire right now, according to preliminary investigation, turns out to be short circuit, but the cops are still probing more details into it. 6 to 8 fire tenders were rushed to the spot. The fire broke out somewhere around 3:30 to 3:45 p.m. today, and the fire broke out on the first floor. And if you look at the area it's very close to the OBC bank. There were certain commercial offices, and more importantly, there was a Tirath Ram hospital that was right next to where the fire broke out. Fortunately, there's been no casualties that have been reported. The fire has been brought under control, but property worth lakhs of rupees have been destroyed in this blaze that was reported in Gurgaon's Patodi Chowk. Of course, the police are trying to ascertain more details about it, but as of now, the fire has been brought under control and no casualties have been reported from that area. Back to you.
Well, we see the blaze, of course, on our screens right now. Also, tell us, Apurva, you mentioned that property worth lakhs has been destroyed, but has anyone been injured?
Well, Amita, no casualties have been reported so far. Since it was a furniture shop, a lot of furniture, of course, have been gutted down, and that is why property worth lakhs of rupees in that area, which is the first floor of the building, that has been damaged due to that fire that broke out. Short circuit is one of the reasons that's been given. The police, of course, probing whether there was other reasons that could have more amounted to this blaze that broke out at 3:30 in the afternoon today. But fortunately, no casualties reported, but of course, lakhs of rupees worth of property has been damaged.
Apurva, getting us details of the massive fire in Gurugram. Their fire is under control right now. No casualties reported so far. Moving on to our top focus. Over the last couple of days, we've been showing you the extent of lawlessness in the state of Haryana. And now, over schoolgirls have taken to the streets in Palwal and Kadarpur in protest against sexual harassment on their way to school. Their demand is that the school in their village be upgraded to senior secondary level, as the nearest senior secondary school is 7 kilometers away. This is not the first time this issue has been brought to light. Remember, last week, schoolgirls in Rewari went on a hunger strike seeking protection against sexual harassment. The government promised to upgrade their school but made no promises to protect them. Milan spoke to the protesting schoolgirls in Kadarpur.
Taking from the protests in Rewari, where the girls from the school in Rewari protested to upgrade their school to a 12th class or 12th grade school. Girls from this particular school in Kadarpur as well took inspiration and protested against the fact that their school should also be upgraded so that they don't have to travel at least 6 kilometers from here to attend another school. In fact, I have a few students who were at the protest. and who were protesting against this. Hame bataiye ki aapko kitni dur jana padta hai yahan se dusre school padhne ke liye.
Hame dusre school padhne ke liye yahan se 6 kilometer dur jana padta hai. Kabhi kabhi hame auto milte hai, kabhi kabhi nahi milte. Aur wahan se jab aate to wo auto wale aise kabhi late kabhi nahi. Bahut problem hote hai ghar pe aake shaam ko 4-5 baje aise lagte hai. Aur isliye hame bahut dikkat hote hai. Raah mein koi koi ladke jo ladkon ko bhi chhedte hai. Humne aise hamare sath hua to nahi par humne bahut zyada aise dekha hai. To isliye us school mein jane ka to aise ji nahi karta hai. पर किसी के माँ बाप ऐसे जो भेजते भी नहीं है लेकिन हमारे माँ बाप तो चलो हम पे विश्वास करके भेजते किसी के इसलिए नहीं भेजते डर के लिए
क्या आपके माँ बाप ने आपसे कहा है कि स्कूल बहुत दूर है तो आप 10वीं के बाद स्कूल मत जाइए
हाँ कहा है बहुत बार कहा है लेकिन हमने अपने पेरेंट्स को बनाया ताकि वो हमें स्कूल भेजे हम कुछ बनना चाहते हैं इसलिए बस इसलिए।
आप क्या बनना चाहते हो बड़े होकर
मैं CA बनना चाहती हूँ CA करना चाहती हूँ अपने पेरेंट्स का हाथ बटाना चाहती हूँ ताकि उन्हें कभी किसी चीज़ के लिए और परेशानी ना हो परेशान ना होना पड़े जो अब वो होते हैं
तो आप स्कूल प्रशासन से और एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर से क्या बोलना चाहेंगे कैसे बताएंगे कि हरियाणा की लड़कियों में कितना दम है
हम ये बताना चाहेंगे हरियाणा के लड़कियों में इतना दम है अगर उन्होंने बोला कि जुलाई में स्कूल वो अपग्रेड कर देंगे अगर नहीं हुआ तो हम दोबारा यहीं पे धरने में बैठ जाएंगे बोलेंगे अगर नहीं करेंगे हमें भूखा प्यासा चक्कर कैसे रहने लगेंगे लेकिन हमें स्कूल का अपग्रेड कर दीजिए
What we know at this point is the principal has informed us that he has indeed written a letter to the Directorate of Education in the Haryana government and that the letter is under process and under consideration. Though today is, few of the last days for the school girls right now, they are waiting for July when, the new session starts and they want this particular school to be upgraded to a 12th class school as you can see that these children have aspirations. These children want to be CAs and doctors and lawyers tomorrow and they don't want their parents telling them ki you cannot go to school just because it's too far for you to travel every day to. In fact, from this particular school, the children have to travel at least 6 kilometers wherein sometimes they do not get the kind of transport that they are supposed to get and hence it is a task for them every day to travel so far. And what we know from authorities is that their proposals are under consideration but what is to be seen is that the incident in Rewari where so many girls have protested and brought the government down to their knees is what these girls are expecting should happen in their area as well.
हमें बारी तक अपना स्कूल चाहिए।
प्लस टू चाहिए क्यों?
क्योंकि हम दूर जाते हैं हमारा स्कूल बहुत दूर है 7 किलोमीटर दूर है वो बादशाहपुर में है
हमारी बहन बादशाहपुर में जाती है वो 7 किलोमीटर दूर है वहाँ के टीचर हमारी बहनों से बहुत चिढ़ते हैं और वो लड़कियों को बहुत सी को फेल भी कर देते हैं इस कारण हमें अपना स्कूल यहाँ पर करवाना चाहते हैं 12वीं तक
हमें यहाँ 12वीं तक स्कूल करवाना चाहते हैं क्योंकि वहाँ जाना पड़ता है वहाँ पर लड़के देखते हैं लड़कियों को बुरी तरह रहता है और ऑटो की प्रॉब्लम आती है बहुत प्रॉब्लम आती है माँ बापों को डर लगा रहता है कोई भेजता है स्कूल में कोई नहीं भेजता इसलिए हम 12वीं तक करवाना चाहते हैं इस स्कूल को पहले से कहते थे कि 12वीं तक हो जाएगा 3 साल हो गए 4 साल हो गए पर लेकिन झूठ बोला जाता है बच्चों से कहते हैं 12वीं तक हो गया लेकिन अब हम कोशिश करेंगे कि 12वीं तक हो ही जाए
स्कूल को अपग्रेड करने के लिए पहले से ही केस भेजा हुआ है नॉर्म्स को स्कूल पूरा करता है तो इसका केस भेजा हुआ है तो इसको अपग्रेडेशन के लिए हमने अभी भी लिखित में हम दे रहे हैं कि हो जाए पहले नॉर्म्स पूरे नहीं कर रहा था तो अब नॉर्म्स पूरे कर रहा है तो हो जाएगा कोई प्रॉब्लम उसमें नहीं है कादरपुर गांव बिल्कुल गुड़गांव के साथ लगा हुआ है और यहां पे स्कूल की डिस्टेंस भी बहुत ज्यादा नहीं है तो सिक्योरिटी का इश्यू अभी तक हमारे पास कोई ऐसा आया नहीं और ना ही किसी तरह कोई कंप्लेंट हमारे पास अभी तक पहुंची
In the meantime, the government's Beti Bachao, Beti Padao program is clearly falling on deaf ears and Haryana Mirror now has been asking the Chief Minister to speak up. Apart from the initial lip service, the Chief Minister has offered no explanation whatsoever. What comes as an update is a tweet where the CM is seen bird watching at a bird sanctuary. And in fact, it gets worse. Look at the visuals of a brute trashing a woman in Haryana's Mirpur district over a petty issue. The very same man who is reportedly the Sarpanch's kin is seen sharing a rather candid moment with Chief Minister Khattar on stage. In fact, lawlessness in Haryana clearly on full display. Let's listen in to the woman who was thrashed by the same guy who is seen with the Chief Minister.
तो मौका थे नहीं, बाद में आई, जैसे भी मेरी घेटी दबाकर मुझे गिरा लिया और मुझे नहीं ना पता मैं क्या तो कहाँ पड़ी हूँ क्या नहीं पड़ी हूँ। और फिर पीछे उठ के नाम कर फिर थाने में गया, थाने में भी इतना गलत शब्द बोले हैं, यहाँ भी इतना बोले हैं, टांग पर टांग धर के मार देंगे, नू मार देंगे और नू कर देंगे, मतलब बहुत ही गलत शब्द, हम कह नहीं सकते सुन नहीं सकते, इतना गंदा गंदा माँ भाण की गाड़ी और घेटी पकड़ पकड़ कर मारना, ये हमारे तो सिर में भी बहुत ज्यादा लग रही है और जी जी बगल में भी घेटी पकड़ ली उसने।
आप दोनों बहने विधवा हैं?
हाँ जी, दोनों भी बहन विधवा हैं और हमारी लड़की भी बगा बगा के मार दी, उसके गोड्डा गाड्डा सब की फोड़ दिया।
कौन कौन थे?
चंद्र बान था जी, रणदीप था और मौके पे सारी उनकी जनानी बुला ली, उन्हें फोन,
सरपंच भी आ गई थी मौके पर,
मौके पे सरपंच भी आ गई थी, मेरे तो वो सरपंच भी गुथरी है सुनीता के।
तो सरपंच और सरपंच का देवर, सरपंच का आदमी, दोनों भी आपको मार रहे हैं?
हाँ मार रहे हैं जी,
जो वीडियो में दिखा देख रहे हैं
जी, दिखा रहे हैं सरपंच और सरपंच का घरवाला, वे दोनों ही मार रहा है मेरे तो।
Brutally beaten up there. In the meantime, the man who was seen beating up a woman over a petty issue in turn says he in fact reacted in self-defense.
तो उन्होंने फोन किया ठेकेदार ने कि यार ये काम नहीं करने देती, ये तो उस पे बैठ गई पाइप पे, पाइप नहीं बिछाने देती। मैंने भाई ऐसा रास्ते का मेन रास्ते का काम है, इस पे तुरंत लेंटर डाल दो, तुरंत इसको बिछा दो, ये गांव का मेन रास्ता है। फिर दोबारा फोन किया, मैंने सरपंच साहब को फ़ोन कर दिया, भाभी लगती थी उनको फ़ोन कर दिया कि आप जाइए और उनको समझा दी, वो गई। उनके जाने के बाद में ये सारे परिवार उसके चिपट गए और उसके पैर पे पहले जाती ईंट मार दी ताकि वो पड़ जाए और फिर ये सारे उसको वो कह रहा। मैं वापिस गाड़ी मोड़ के फिर दोबारा आया जी, आया तो मैंने देखा भाई तू तुम क्यों ऐसा कर रही हो, तुम्हारे रास्ते में नहीं ये सरकारी रास्ता, क्यों ऐसा कर रही हो। इस ये बावजूद कहने के बावजूद इन्होंने काफ़ी गाली गलौच, और फिर मैंने उन देखा, उन्होंने मेरे सारे हालात बताई, कहने मेरे साथ ये किए और फिर इन्होंने मेरे यहाँ हाथ डाला। और ये हाथ डालने के बाद में जब मैंने अपने छूट छुटाव के लिए और फिर मैंने ये
कपड़े पाड़ दिए,
हाँ कपड़े पाड़ दिए और मैंने हाथापाई करने लगा।
Now that is the state of affairs in Haryana, and this is despite Mirror Now's non-stop coverage of the apathy. 3 days after we took up the Sonipat rape and murder case where police officials had delayed FIR, two officers were suspended. However, we're not stopping there. We demand legal action against the police who deliberately refused to file an FIR in this case. In Sonipat, for the 7th consecutive day, people have taken to the streets demanding justice for Nirbhaya of Rohtak. Listening to a Congress MLA who was at the protest.
Nirbhaya जैसे कांड हुआ है रोहतक में, इसके लिए आए हैं, सोनीपत की वो लड़की है, और जैसे निर्भया के साथ हुआ तो पूरा हिंदुस्तान इकट्ठा हो गया था। आज इस बच्ची के लिए कोई भी आगे नहीं आ रहा, तो मैं तो हरियाणा सरकार से कहूँगी जो सोई हुई है कि इस बच्ची के साथ जिन लोगों ने ये गैंगरेप किया है और इतनी बदसलूकी करके उसका मर्डर किया है तो उनको सख्त से सजा दी जाए।
We're not stopping here on the urban debate tonight at 9 as the Haryana jungle raj continues. We demand Chief Minister Khattar's resignation and demand action as soon as possible. Live up to the promise of Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Also on the show now, another case of violence against women coming out of Haryana's Ambala. This time, a newly married woman died after consuming a poisonous substance. The victim's family has accused the groom's family of causing her death by demanding dowry. Now, the police have registered a case against the groom and his parents.
मैंने जो लड़की मरी मरी मिली है जी।
हाँ जी, क्या लगता है आपको?
हाँ
क्या लगता है?
इन्हें मारी है जी, मैंने आपने आप हाथा देखे मुँह पर थप्पड़ मारे करके नखान चले गए थे। हाँ जी, लगता बाजी उंगली रोड़ी भी आएगा। हाँ जी,
अब क्या मांगे?
हाँ
क्या मांगे पुलिस से आपकी?
मांग तो मारी हुई है, इन्हें बंदा गिरफ्तार करो जी। अंदर
ये रुपिंदर कौर लड़की है कार्की की, इसकी शादी करीब 6 महीने पहले हुई थी, तो आज मैं सूचना प्राप्त हुई थी कि रुपिंदर कौर की मौत होगी और डेड बॉडी सिविल हॉस्पिटल अंबाला कैंट हुई है। यहाँ मौके पर आए लड़की के चाचा मिले, उनका बयान लिख के मुकदमा दर्ज कर दिया और पोस्टमार्टम करा के आगे कार्रवाई अमल में लाई नहीं अभी किसी को गिरफ्तार नहीं करा पोस्टमार्टम के बाद उन्हें गिरफ्तार करेंगे तीन लोगों के खिलाफ लड़की के चाचा के बयान पे पर्चा दर्ज लड़की का पति ससुर और सास
Moving on to Delhi now, parents gathered in large numbers outside the Queen Mary School, and here's why. They were protesting after the school's cab driver allegedly abused a student. Now, parents allege that despite repeated requests, the school principal has not taken any action in the case and adequate security measures have not yet been taken.
आपकी बच्ची यहाँ पर पढ़ती है, आपने कंप्लेन की है कि यहाँ बसेस में या वैन्स में GPRS वगैरह नहीं है।
नहीं हमने पहले कंप्लेन करा था तो बस में तो लग गई है लेकिन वो वैन में नहीं आती है, वो प्री नर्सरी की बच्ची है और उसी रूट में आती है जिस रूट में ये हादसा हुआ है वो अकेली आती है मेरे कॉलोनी से
तो इन्होंने बोला था कि एक लेडी गार्ड देंगे वैन के लिए
मैं अपना कंप्लेन लिखवा के गया हूँ ये बोला कि आगे से हम लेडी वो देंगे गार्ड देंगे लेकिन अभी तक नहीं आया कोई
आज ये लेडी गार्ड एक दिन आता है एक दिन नहीं आता मॉर्निंग में आता है इवनिंग में नहीं आता जबकि ट्रांसपोर्ट सारा स्कूल ही स्टाफ मैनेज करता है सारी फीस स्कूल लेता है पर कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है मतलब आंसर नहीं कोई आंसरेबल नहीं है प्रिंसिपल आंसर नहीं करती है किसी भी चीज का एक हफ्ते का टाइम मांगते हैं सामने नहीं आती है फीस लेने के लिए आप सामने आते हैं तो आप आंसर देने के लिए क्यों नहीं आते हैं
एज आफ्टर पेइंग दैट मच मनी वी फेल्ट दैट आफ्टर सो मच टाइम नो GPRS हैज बीन इंस्टॉल्ड इन ऑल द व्हीकल्स and also the drivers doesn't come in uniform they don't wear their I cards and there is no lady attendant in the class because it's a girl school and we are concerned for the safety of our child because we believe that we are children are safe at our house but we want to send the children to school for education but if school is not providing safety and security to the child then how we can trust the school authorities that yes they will take proper care of our children they are not providing any lady attendant in the van even after so much time and they are waiting for another incident to happen and we are not ready to face another incident of child molestation.
इंक्वायरी हैज बीन इनिशिएटेड बाय द पुलिस अथॉरिटीज में जो हमारा उस समय का दायित्व था उसको हैंड ओवर करना भी है डन वी आर नॉट कोर्ट वी कैन नॉट वी आर ऑल्सो कॉपरेटिंग व्हाट डू यू वांट फ्रॉम अस कोई भी कमर्शियल वैन विदाउट GPRS पास ही नहीं होता है इनफैक्ट जो वैन पकड़ा गया था उसमें भी GPRS लगा हुआ है यू कैन चेक विद द रिकॉर्ड
उस दिन उसके अलावा कि क्या फिटनेस सर्टिफिकेट है सिलेंडर का कि गाड़ी के सिलेंडरों की फिटनेस सर्टिफिकेट है जो कल इतना बड़ा हादसा हुआ टला ITO के ऊपर क्या वो बच्चों के साथ होगा तो कौन जिम्मेवार होगा
सर सब उस पेपर उसकी गाड़ी के सभी पेपर विद GPRS सबमिटेड हैं पुलिस रिकॉर्ड्स में यू कैन वेरीफाई
Moving on to Mumbai now, in yet another case of discrimination by the society, a woman is not being allowed to claim her mother's flat in a Versova society because of her animal welfare activities. Now, animal lover Aarti Gupta claims that she has been facing hostility from the society's management and they have also blocked the transfer of her flat. Now, the flat was brought by her own mother who died 8 years ago. Richa Sharma files this report.
That's right, I'm currently standing in the Versova area in Mumbai, right outside the Gitanjali Cooperative Housing Society area. It's a residential complex where a 42-year-old lady by the name of Aarti Gupta has allegated that the society members from the past 8 years have not transferred the name of the flat which belonged to her mother in her name despite giving the necessary documentation, despite the registrar's orders that were stated by her and trying to speak to the management committee members, the chairman of the management committee of the Cooperative Housing Society. They denied to talk to us on camera, but our sources from the management are stating that the matter is sub judice in court and they would not like to comment much on it and they are waiting for the court's order for the transfer to happen so far. And what is important here to note is that the lady in the question, Aarti Gupta, is allegating that because she is an animal lover and because of her love for the animals and the stray cats that she keeps on adopting, that's the reason that the members and the committee members are raising their voice and not letting the transfer of the name happen. So far, the lady in the question is stating that she wants justice and she wants that the name gets transferred as soon as possible, and she's willing to fight till the very end. But why this matter is of great significance is because in the city of Mumbai, time and again, we see that there is a lot of discrimination as well as issues raised by the society committee members when it comes to on the basis of gender, caste, creed, religion, and this time also for the animal lovers in this case. This is Rajesh Sharma for Mirror Now Mumbai.
The registrar had to send an authorized police office, officer and the police under the police protection and transfer the flat in my name and confiscate the records. Once they confiscated the records and they put my name on the share certificate and on the IG register, these people again went to the court, to the registrar's office, joint registrar's office. We want to condone the delay and, you know, she gets goons in the society and she got ups and she tried to grease our palm and all that. That means you're trying to tell me the police were the goons. The registrar is a got up. I am a got up. And you people are having antisocial elements in the society and you people are not aware of that.
She's a certified member of PFA and she's a member of the Animal Board of India also. And regularly, it is all the incidents through which we have come to the conclusion that they are doing this thing. There must be some other angle also, this thing. They are the chairman is a property broker, and even the secretary is a property, and there are a lot of property broker in the society managing committee also. I don't know what is the reason why they are not accepting maintenance checks and this thing, and they must be having some other investor interest in this thing, so they want to make us a defaulter in making the payment and just push us out from this flat.
What we came to know is that it's not the first incident. They have been passive-aggressive about this thing since, I guess, 2011. You know, they'll passively, like, you know, ask her to stop feeding, harass her, so that her spirit breaks, basically. But every citizen of the country, under the constitutional right, that's 51AG, you're supposed to be compassionate towards animals. And like, that's exactly what she's being.
Let's also take a look at what else is making news now. Four people were killed in Chobapur village in Jamshedpur on the suspicion of kidnapping children. One out of the four was beaten to death immediately. Three managed to escape but were eventually lynched by other villagers. Shocking statement coming from Himachal Pradesh Chief Minister. When asked about deaths due to swine flu, the CM said that such instances keep taking place in areas which are populated. Two dead and several rescued in the footbridge collapse in South Goa on Thursday evening. The collapsed part of the bridge has been removed. Navy divers are still at the spot and rescue operations are underway. Delhi High Court has asked Arun Jaitley's counsel to file an application to find out whether Jaitmalani used the word crook after being provoked by Delhi CM Arvind Kejriwal, saying that if it is proved, then it would amount to an aggravated defamation case against him. BJP Chief Amit Shah will begin his two-day visit to Chandigarh from May 20th as a part of his 95-day countrywide tour. Keeping an eye on the 2019 general elections, Shah is out to strengthen party position across all the states. Now, the BJP chief will also be reviewing the organizational activities of his party. Terrorists lobbed a hand grenade on a police station in Srinagar on Thursday. Two policemen and one civilian have been injured. And the GST or the Goods and Service Tax Council on Thursday has come up with a tax list of 1,211 commodities. Essential commodities have been included in the 5% tax bracket, while tea and coffee have been included in the 10% tax bracket. Cereals, milk and food grains are exempt. Also on the show now, superstar Rajinikanth addressed fans today in Chennai, hitting back at those calling him an outsider. The superstar said that the people of Tamil Nadu have made him a Tamilian. However, Rajinikanth still looked in no mood to clear the air surrounding his much talked about political debut.
நான் ரஜினிகாந்த் தமிழன் தான், அவர் தமிழன் தான் அப்படின்னு நான் கேள்வி எனக்கு இப்போ வந்து 67 வயசு ஆகுது. 23 ஆண்டு தான் நான் கர்நாடகத்தில் இருந்தேன். 44 ஆண்டுகள் உங்க கூடவே வளர்ந்த கர்நாடகத்திலிருந்து ஒரு மராட்டியனோ ஒரு கன்னடக்காரனவோ நான் இங்கே வந்திருந்தா கூட நீங்கள் என்னை ஆதரித்து அன்பு கொடுத்து பேரும் பகலும் பணம் எல்லாத்தையும் அள்ளி கொடுத்து என்னை வந்து நீங்களாக தமிழவே ஆக்கிட்டீங்க. நான் பச்சை தமிழர். வெளியே போ அப்படின்னு சொன்னா தூக்கி போட்டா நான் இமயமலையில போய் தான் விழுவேன் தவிர வேறு எந்த மாநிலத்தில் போய் விட மாட்டேன். தமிழ் மக்கள் நல்ல மக்கள் நல்ல உள்ளங்கள் இருக்கிற பூமியில இருந்தா இங்கே இருக்கிறோம். இதை ரசித்தர்கள் இருக்கிற
On that note, we'll have to wrap things up here on this bulletin. More news and updates coming up on the other side.